Tonight I'm gonna leave it in
my heart.
Tonight I'm gonna leave it in
my soul.
Tonight I'm gonna leave it in
my mind.
Tonight I'm gonna leave it in
for you.
Tonight I'm gonna leave it in.
Put your hands together and show a whole lot of love for my friend Eric Roberson.
In the late 90s, I lost, my car got broken into the day I was moving away from Atlanta, and the only thing they stole was my music collection, was really the music I had recorded up to that point. So all my high school music, all my college music, and all of the 2 years out of college that I made, you know, hundreds of songs that we recorded were gone in an instant. And I think the only way to really handle it is just to work. It wasn't a thing of like, I couldn't really invest in time of, to this day I still haven't, in like trying to get those songs back. The best way for me to heal was to write another song and write about it, right? Like take that pain and put it into, you know, put it into music and let that resonate more.
I had a session with Joe and Uncle Sam. I remember Uncle Sam. So I had Joe in one room and Uncle Sam in another room, and I'm going back and forth. And at this point, I was really popping in Atlanta, but I just wasn't comfortable in Atlanta. It wasn't what I wanted to do. And I was exhausted. And Joe said, I got a concert I got to run to. I'm going to do this show, and I'll come right back. So while he went to the show, I was like, I could just go to a friend's house and just crash for a minute, just get some rest. I'm driving to New Jersey the next day. So when I go back to my truck is packed. My apartment is empty. Everything's in the truck. There's broken glass around. I'm like, that's weird.
Wow.
The only thing missing is a book bag that was in the front that had all my music I had recorded. Literally every song, the Warner Brothers album, all the Atlanta stuff, all the touch jazz stuff I just did. And that's the only thing they took. I didn't take the little TV I had, a little chest with clothes. And they took, the only thing they took was the book bag. So that was tough. I mean, I tell people I probably could track down a couple of songs from like my good friend, the girlfriend I dated at the time, really, but it was so catastrophic for me that it was like, let's just start from song one. Let's just start over. And so that was a tough one. Like I think somebody played me a song, of one of those songs, and I was just like, I hadn't heard it in like 20 years. You know?
So did you ever find out who took that thing, man?
I probably was like a crackhead or something. Just looking.
It had to be somebody.
And he opened the book back like, you know. But I mean, I don't think it was like somebody trying to, if they wanted to steal my music, they could have stole the music any other kind of
thing. Was this like handwritten songs and?
No, it was DATs, cassettes. Oh, okay. This was just really coming out with discs. It was like all the DATs, all the cassettes, all the stuff I've done. It was like a big duffel bag, or whatever. And it just had all. I mean, it was, that's why I packed up the lead. And I think they was, you know, they were probably looking for some money or whatever. And then instead of just putting it back, when they saw it was just a whole bunch of DATs and cassette tapes, they just probably threw it in the soup. I mean, I drove around for blocks. Praying I would see a bag sitting there or a tape or anything that was a tough one. We got over it.
And that's the thing, man. I think you take it's songwriting and really probably in all things, you take every piece of formula, every piece of material, everything you can have. I've heard a long time ago a steam engine, they say you know it's the train is pushed with fire. And that same fire can burn down buildings, can really hurt you and pain you, and yet at the same time it can also create enough energy to push a train for miles and miles and miles. So I think the same thing with our own pain. We use it and we internalize it and put it as gasoline for something else. And that's what I did. I was, you know, to this day, and I can't say I'm happy that it happened, but I think the person I am today is because it happened.
I had one expectation when coming here. I thought it was going to be a teaching workshop, literally taking notes. And my expectations were exceeded, because not only did you receive lessons, not only was I taking notes, but I was also awakened to more realizations about what else is inside that needs to be pushed out. What else does not, the dreams that don't need to be, that I don't need to let go of. And so I was further inspired and further empowered by this great event. So excited about that. Yeah.